impeachment trial of Supreme Court Chief Justice Renato Corona is on a temporary break as the prosecution makes a formal written offer of its evidence. As this report also tells us, the impeachment court cited a private prosecutor for contempt for disrespecting Senator Judge Miriam Defensor Santiago.
The impeachment trial of Chief Justice Renato Corona will go on a two-week break to give his lawyers time to present their defense. And while on break, the prosecution will submit its formal offer of evidence and the defense their objections. This is after prosecutors decided to drop 5 of the 8 articles of impeachment against Corona and rest their case, a move that irked Senator Judge Miriam Santiago.
In my entire career as an RTC judge of Quezon City, I have never seen a lawyer in a civil case, which is in this instance parallel to an impeachment trial, withdraw any cause of action that he told the court he would present evidence on. I felt like creeping back into bed and adopting a fetal position, which is the normal reaction of any sane person when he's faced with a world that is crumbling around him. I no longer know what universe I am in.
Santiago also admonished the prosecution for declaring in media that they've already established an overwhelming case against the Chief Justice.
You are engaging, gentlemen, in a public discourse on the merits of your case. You're not supposed to say that at all. Ang yayabang ng mga nagsasalita na ganyan, ang gago naman. Ay, my goodness. Ang kakaguhan is a ground for contempt of court.
While Santiago was berating the prosecution, one of its members, private prosecutor Vitaliano Aguirre, was seen covering his ears.
This is a travesty. Una sabi nyo, malakas na malakas ang ebidensya namin kasi 8 ang krimen niya. Pagkatapos ngayon, 2 buwan pa lang, wala na. 3 na lang sa 5. Kasi tama na yun, panalo na kami. Wah! I request the secretariat should record in our journal that I said, wah! Where are your neurons? Where are your synapses? Your brains are very, very dark.
Vitaliano's gesture did not sit well with Senator Judge Jingoy Estrada.
Nakalagay po ang inyong kamay sa inyong tek. At para bagang ayaw niyo siyang pakinggan.
Totoo po
yan. Po ay isang kapastusan dito po sa isang miyembro ng hukom na ito.
Alam po, totoo po yun. Sapagkat nasasaktan na yung tainga ko. Ang pinakami-importante po sa isang tao ay respeto. Ang nagdidemand, kung nagdidemand ka ng respeto, dapat respetuhin mo dun itong mga
Mr.
abogadong
President.
Ito.
Presiding Officer Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile called for calm and suspended the hearing to break the tension. Santiago then approached Aguirre to confront him.
Hi.
When the session resumed, the impeachment court ruled to cite Aguirre for contempt.
I must say that I cannot tolerate any disrespect of this court and to any member of this court as a presiding officer. It was a sign of his disrespect to a member of this court, and that cannot be allowed to pass. And it must be dealt with accordingly.
On behalf of the prosecution, we would like to express our regrets for what happened to the Honorable Court, especially to the lady from Iloilo.
From here on, all concerned must take note of this. We will no longer tolerate a misbehavior like this.
Speaking to ANC, Santiago's colleagues said they support the presiding officer's decision.
Sabi ko nga, kung sa Supreme Court niya ginawa yun, anak, contempt din yun. You can disagree with what the judge is saying or giving a sermon on. No, you can disagree. Mm-hmm. Pero wag naman yung to protest in front of the judge.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Inamin niya at inaano niya yung korte. So mm-hmm. maybe the best punishment for him is to 24 hours at pakinggan si Senator Miriam.
Aguirre no longer commented on the matter as he was escorted out of the Senate by the Sergeant at Arms and House prosecutors. Enrile says Senator judges will discuss the penalty for Aguirre in a caucus next week. The trial will resume on March 12th when defense lawyers begin presenting their evidence and witnesses.
On Wednesday, what could have been the shortest impeachment trial day was extended as Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago again berated the prosecution. One private prosecutor, Vitaliano Aguirre, was unable to stand yet another admonition and was clearly seen covering his ears while the senator judge was speaking. This led the court to find him in contempt. And joining us this morning is none other than the private prosecutor himself, Vitaliano Aguirre. You can also join our discussion by tweeting your questions and comments to ANC Mornings, and we'll make sure to have a copy given and or even read to Attorney Vit Aguirre. We'll talk about Twitter a little later on in the newscast. I was asking Attorney Vitaliano Aguirre if he knew Twitter, but he said old lawyers apparently are not very tech savvy. All right. Attorney, I know this happened yesterday. Can you just give us again what happened? What were you thinking and why you did what you did?
Actually, ito ate sapin-sapin ang mga pangyayari. Kasi maraming mga araw na nagdaan na ang prosecution ay talagang palaging nasesermonan, nabiberate ni Senator Miriam Santiago. So, marami rin sa kanila nagpipigil na hindi nila mga gagawin kung ano ang gusto nila para lang may pahatid nila kung ano ang kanilang nasasaloob tungkol sa ginagawang ito. Kasi sinabi ko rin kahapon na hindi naman talaga procedure sa court na ang isang judge ay magle-lecture muna o magse-sermon muna bago mag-start ang trial. Actually, bihirang-bihira nga na ang isang judge ay magse-sermon o lalaitin ang mga abogado. Kaya't siguro because of that, nung una ay hindi ko naman tinatakpan yung tenga ko, pero sa totoo lang, talagang malakas ang dating sa tenga ko. Kasi yung boses ni Senator Miriam on the is real at this was done and on the top of her voice. Kaya talagang tinakpan ko lang muna, and then afterwards, hindi ko na rin gustong marinig yung mga pag-sermon sa prosecution. So that's it. What happened, happened.
Mm. Any regrets about what happened, about what you did?
No regrets. Actually, I feel, and I look at this, that I was just made an instrument. Na ang feeling ng others ay may parating sa all concern.
Sabi niyo po, patong-patong na po yung pagsasermon. Sabi niyo, unusual po yun para sa isang judge na gawin yun in front of lawyers. But some lawyers were saying that meron naman po sarang paraan yung pong maybe do a written manifestation that sa palagay niyo medyo naaapi na yung mga prosecutors doon sa mga paninermo ni Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago. Didn't you think of that?
Ay, palagay ko wala mangyayari doon eh. Kasi I think the prosecutors, both public and private, they voiced already in the past their opinions on the subject matter. Mm. But walang nangyayari. Ganon din araw-araw. Mm. Before the start of the actual trial, nandun siya at nagsisermon, calling us names. I think kahapon lang, dalawang beses niyang tawagin ng prosecution na JAGO. Mm-mm. So, I believe that what I did is yun lang ang minimum na nakikita ko para at least somebody would stand up sa mga ginagawa sa prosecution.
That Senator Jinggoy Estrada actually tried to speak to you at sinabi, yung ginagawa niyo po ay pambabastos yan. Do you agree or not?
Actually, may counting mali doon pero hindi ko binabastos kailanman ng impeachment court. As a matter of fact, I have great respect for the Senate President. He is very fair. As a matter of fact, he gave me a chance to explain. Pero yung ginawa kong yun, I thought na dapat pinalampas na lamang ng ilan nila. Sapagkat pinalalampas naman nila yung ibang nag-overstep ang bounds ang ibang mga senators. Even the yung ginawa ng defense noon na nagsasabi na meron daw 100 million for each of the senators, eh nakalampas din yun ng walang masyado. Kung tutusin, mas grabe yun kaysa sa pagtakip ng tenga ko.
And yet, you have been cited for contempt.
Yes.
Nung nagsalita po si Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago, dahil nga nalaman niya na you were covering your ears, as eventually, sabi po ni Senate President, 1 minute ano, suspension, a couple of minutes suspension. Lumapit po sa inyo si Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago. Do you remember what exactly what she was saying?
Well, not exactly, but like this. He told me, talagang hinahamon mo ba ako? Anong gusto mo? Parang ganun. Parang nag-ahamon ng away, but hindi ko napinansin yun.
What were the prosecutors telling you? Kasi nakita ko, in a way, they surrounded you, tapos parang pinapalabas na
yeah.
po kayo.
Ang sabi sa akin ng prosecutors, aliga, lumabas na lang tayo. Anyway, binigyan ka na ng parang permission ni Senator Miriam na lumabas na.
Oo. Because you actually said, di ba, you wanted to walk out.
Yes.
Yes.
But you could not do it from the place that I was in yesterday. Kasi nasa gitna ako ng mesa. Hindi ka maaring tumindig doon nang hindi titindig at aalisin yung silya ng mga katabi ko. Pinakasentro talaga ako noon.
Would it be fair to say that at that point, parang punong-puno ka na? Kaya nyo ginawa yun?
Something like it.
I see. Okay, but you know, when nung bumalik po si nung nag-resume po yung session, prior to that, let me go back. When you were being asked, sabi mo, "Oo, pa, well, please correct me if I'm wrong, Attorney Vita, no? Pero parang sinasabi mo na, "Oo, sinadya mo talagang i-cover dahil shrill yung boses." I remember you saying that. Dahil ayaw niyo na marinig. Do you regret saying that? I mean, could it have been possible na siguro pinaikot mo na lang at hindi mo na lang sinabi yung katotohanan yung iyong nararamdaman? Any regrets in saying that or hindi naman po?
No regret. I think that's the only way to join the issue.
Okay. All right. So lumabas na po kayo. Congressman Fariñas went to the podium and said he wanted to let the impeachment court know their regrets for what happened. Unfortunately, that thing happened, and the private prosecutors were supposed to be under the control of the public prosecutor. Sumama ho ba loob niyo nung sinabing regrets from Congressman Fariñas?
Hindi naman. Kasi si Congressman Fariñas, talagang may misgiving siya. Yun tungkol dun sa pagpa-strike out ng word na GAGO. Tapos nag-decide siya later on na wag na lang. But I prompted him, mga congressman kayo, dapat paalis niyo sa record yun.
And so ikaw pa pala nag-udyok nun? Ay, kayo.
Pero mayroon na siyang idea talaga na ipa-strike off the record yung remarks na yan.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so now that it's actually happened, Attorney Vit, I know napag-uusapan na po ito since kahapon. Are you going to make an apology to the senator because of what happened?
I have already apologized to her. Kung nasaktan ko yung damdamin niya for what I did, I apologize deeply.
And that's a public apology right there on national
it's
television.
It's my second public apology on national television.
All right. Well, thanks for answering that. But I'd like to move forward. On Monday, magkakaroon po ng caucus. Kayo ho ba'y nervous na baka sakaling makulong kayo o i-fine kayo? Kasi pag-uusapan pa po nila kung ano ang penalty for Attorney Vita Aguirre.
Whatever the consequences of my action, I did it voluntarily. I'll be open to accepting any penalty on me.
Okay. Twitter po. Just to let our viewers know that I was talking to Attorney Vit Aguirre about Twitter kasi trending siya kahapon. Apparently, Attorney Vit does not know much about Twitter. So, ang lumalabas ho kasi sa Twitter, Attorney Vit, meron po mga taong kumakampi sa'yo, sinasabing saludo kami sa ginawa nyo dahil sobra na si Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago. Yung iba naman, sinasabi, bastos yung ginawa ninyo. Dalawa pong panig yan. Mayroong sumasaludo, mayroong nagalit sa inyo at dapat daw nirespeto nyo yung mga senator judges. We have a couple of Twitter followers who would like to give them or let you know about their sentiments. From Zilly Seth, how much is your fine? I will contribute. Bravo to what you did. Wala pa, no, sir? Wala pang fine. All right, from Boom Boom 113, Attorney Aguirre, do you think it's actually Senator Estrada's fault? He could have just called your attention after the proceedings.
Well, I would not say that it is the fault of the senator. Actually, tulad ng sinabi ko nina, sana pinalampas na lang yon. I just want to convey a feeling by a single prosecutor about what's happening. So siguro, kung pinalampas na lang yon and then kinausap nila ang kung sino mang concerned na Senate juror, eh baka hindi na nangyari yung nangyari kahapon.
Pero siguro, Attorney Aguirre, ang hirap din na palampasin dahil hitang-kita kayo sa camera. Talagang kahit po yung camera ng ABS-CBN ay pagpan, ay nakita ho talaga kayong kaganoon. And because you were right there.
I admit it, that's my mistake.
Yeah.
But sometimes you have to commit some little mistake para lang to convey what you want to convey.
Meron ho ba kayong samanan loob dun sa ibang mga senador? For example, Senator si Alan Peter nagsumbong, si Senator Jinggoyan tumayo, si Senator Pia Cayetano nag-second ng motion to cite you for contempt.
Wala po akong sa samanan loob na kahit ano. Pagkat alam ko naman na I feel that they are just doing their duty in good faith.
So from here on, Attorney Aguirre, tanggal na ho ba kayo? Kinausap ko na ba kayo ng prosecutors at sinabi, tanggal ka na muna sa kaso o umalis ka muna?
Actually, ako po ang, I told them that I will voluntarily withdraw from as a private prosecutor and perhaps I'll be making my motion this afternoon. Kaya, anyway, it would not be effective anymore because I could not join the prosecution in a pool of cross-examiners. Sana yun nga sanang maganda eh, because the prosecution needs very good cross-examiners kasi in discrediting the witnesses to be presented by the defense.
By the defense. That you were looking forward to that, of course, aside from, but dahil assigned po kayo sa Article 3 at Article 1.
Well, na-scrap ngayon sa Article 3 tungkol dun sa pag-usap ni Chief Justice Corona sa mga litigants pending before the Supreme Court. And the other one, I would have been presenting Attorney Romel Bagares, lawyer of the petitioners in the North Rail case, where in this case, Chief Justice Corona singly and not collegially stopped the hearing of the case in the RTC of the North Rail case. At pinadala niya sa Supreme Court yung kaso. Up to now, nakapending yung kasong yun. It is another, I believe, instance where Chief Justice Corona is approved singly an action in a case that is favorable to the administration of GMA.
I see. Okay, so yung pong sinasabi nyo kanina, Attorney Aguirre, na are you going to just do a written, ano ba yung manifestation to the public prosecutors na kayo'y aalis na sa prosecution?
Yeah, I would like to apologize also to the public prosecution and to the other private prosecutors for what I did. Kung ito man ay maka-adversely affect sa amin, but I hope it did not. It will be, I told yesterday that would be the last time that I'll be appearing as public prosecutor in the said case.
Just again, looking forward, I'm sure you're not looking forward to Monday, but what's going to happen on Monday dahil meron talagang kailangan na, sanctions sa inyo. What is the most that you think you deserve na yung pinakamasama siguro na pwede nilang ipataw na penalty sa iyo because of you admit naman may mali doon sa inyo.
Yeah, I admit. Yeah. Actually,
would it be
I leave it to the impeachment court. Well, under the rules yata kasi hindi pa masyadong definite ang imposition ng penalty. It could be a fine or imprisonment or both. Sa bahala na sila po.
So, palagay niyo po, sir, kaya niyo yung, okay lang sa inyo yung maiwan doon? Saan ba yun kung kayo makukulong sa
really
Senado ba?
I really don't know. It's really the call really of the Senate. But wherever, whenever.
Mm-mm. It could be in the Senate or it could be something else. Well, you know, Senator Alan Peter Cayetano made light at sabi niya na, well, baka siguro pwedeng ikulong daw kayo in 24 hours tapos manermon daw si Senator William Defensor Santiago. Ano ho ba yun? Is that enough punishment?
I think that's a joke.
All right, so here's another question from Twitter from Pox Divina Phil. Why apologize if what you think you did is right?
I did not apologize for what I did. I'm apologizing if I caused Senator Miriam Santiago some discomfort, but not for what I did.
So let's make it clear. Ginawa niyo, hindi niyo po, you are not regretting what you did, but you regret having caused this whole commotion because of what you did.
Yeah, tama, and especially to Senator Miriam.
Senator Miriam, Defensor Santiago. All right, Attorney Vitaguirre, I'm sure that message will get to the senator, and we'll see on Monday what happens. And well, good luck, sir. That will be the last time we'll be seeing you in the impeachment court.
Yes, thank you very much.
All right, Attorney Vitaguirre there. Thank you again, sir. Stay tuned. When we come back, Paolo will talk.